Florida Department of Environmental Protection, under its authority to implement the Federal Clean Water Act, enacted the state's Surface Water Quality Standards Regulation to classify surface waters according to designated uses. All the water bodies in the Paynes Prairie watershed are classified as Class 3 waters, which means they should support recreation and healthy fish and wildlife populations. Water bodies not meeting the standards of the classification for different pollutants are called impaired, which is determined by the methodology given under Florida's Impaired Waters Rule. The Clean Water Act also requires states to establish total maximum daily loads, TMDLs. TMDLs set limits on the amounts of different pollution allowed to enter impaired water bodies each year. In 1999, the state passed the Florida Watershed Restoration Act in order to establish its TMDL program. Strategies to achieve the TMDLs are identified and assigned to local jurisdictions through basin management plans. The Sweetwater Branch Watershed and the adjacent Tumblin Creek Watershed fall within the larger Paynes Prairie Watershed. Within the Paynes Prairie Watershed, Sweetwater Branch, Tumblin Creek, and Alachua-Sink are all considered impaired and have TMDLs. Their management strategies are included within the larger Orange Creek Basin Management Action Plan, also known as a BMAP. This plan includes specific management actions and projects designed to address water quality issues within the watershed. The Depot Park and Sweetwater Wetlands projects are two of the projects designed to help address these water quality issues within the watershed, which we'll be learning about more later in this tour. The Orange Creek BMAP build upon existing water quality improvement programs and local partnerships, such as the Gainesville Clean Water Partnership between the city, county, and the Florida Department of Transportation. The Clean Water Partnership was established as a result of municipal separate storm sewer system permitting requirements. The BMAP is overseen by an interagency basin working group and the Florida Department of Environmental Protection. Each entity responsible for implementing the BMAP strategies must submit an annual report. The BMAP also outlines a water quality monitoring program to be used to assess progress and identify new actions as part of the plan's adaptive management process. The 2019 BMAP amendment set a date of 2028 for achieving the TMDL targets for all impaired water bodies in the Orange Creek Basin, which is 20 years after the Phase 1 BMAP was adopted.